desalination. Now, desalination is the next big thing, but it is not yet very cost effective. Isn't that right? The energy consumption is high. How can we optimize the energy consumption and reduce the cost of water? How do we make it happen? I mean, and how soon into the future do we see it becoming more cost effective?
Okay, let me say a few things. First, put it into perspective, because obviously desalinating seawater is more energy inefficient than it is just getting water from a lake or a river or an aquifer. But in perspective of many of the things that we do in our life that we assume as natural, it really is something that we can definitely justify. Like running air conditioning for 1 hour in a home is the same equivalent energy that we use to provide that home or that family with seawater desalination. Running on a jet plane, like a 747 jet plane with four engines, consumes the same power as three very large desalination plants can provide a whole city. So the jet plane carries 300 people around the world, but the desalination plants, three of them, can provide water for 1.5 million people. So in general, when we compare it to other things that we see in our life, seawater desalination is becoming something that is justifiable. The second thing that I would say is that we've spent the last 40 years developing technology and developing designs to reduce the energy consumption, because it was the single most important cost of a seawater desalination plant. So today, we're at the point where the thermodynamic minimum is almost there, it's almost achieved. We started doing desalination with no energy recovery devices. Today we have energy recovery devices that recycle that energy with 97% efficiency. So we're very close to the limit. Now, what else can we do? We keep going. We keep designing new membranes, new technologies, new pretreatment solutions, new designs. What we can do is eventually couple this to desalination to renewable energy, to solar, to wind, to the renewable energy that is coming and that is becoming more affordable. As energy becomes more affordable, seawater desalination will become more affordable. And we are reaching economies of a scale also where the price of water, another example, we were used to pay maybe half a dollar or a dollar even for half a liter of water in a bottled water in a Starbucks. We can desalinate seawater for 50 cents per cubic meter, per 1,000 liters. So this is 2,000.